guys, thanks for stopping by Scraps of Mine. So I'm back. I know it's been a while. It's just been a really crazy past couple months. So I'm hoping to get back into things and start showing you some things I've been creating and just start creating more. It's just been a really busy past couple months, like I said. So anyways, today I'm going to share with you a scrapbook haul from the Scrapbook Expo. And I went today and had a fun time. It was a nice, beautiful day, and I was really pleased with the expo this year. In the past years, it hasn't been very big here in Denver, and so I was very pleased with the amount of vendors that were there, and there were a lot of people, and so the word is getting out, and more people are coming, and I'm thinking next year we'll probably have even more vendors, so I'm really excited about that. So I'm going to share with you what I bought, and before I do that, you're going to see all the stuff I bought, and you're going to be like, holy cow, she bought a lot of stuff, she must have spent a lot of money, but nope, I didn't even spend $100, so I'm so proud of myself, but I spent my money very wisely, I think, on things that I feel that I will use. I tried not to buy a lot of paper, but you know how that goes. You always find some paper that you like. But I love to buy embellishments, so that's usually what I shop for. So enough with my rambling, and I'm going to share with you what I got. All right, so the first booth that I bought stuff at was the Eyelet Outlet, and I didn't buy any eyelets, obviously. And I apologize for this camera. My other camera is dead, and so I'm having to use a different one that I don't typically do videos on, so bear with me. So I bought a bunch of the enamel dots. So this is the silver, and it's really pretty. So I got two of the silver and then two of the gold, and then I got two of these hearts with the circles. Just love those colors. And then I got some arrows. And there's the purple and turquoise and green. And then black, white, gold, and silver arrows. And then I got this 4th of July one. Cute. And then I got these jewels. They're sticky back jewels. And they're just white like circles. But they look like snowflakes to me. And I thought they'd be really pretty with a winter layout maybe. So that's what I got at the Eyelet Outlet. And then I went to another booth that was new this year, and it was called Scrapping for Less, and everything there was a dollar. And all these eyelets and that were like $1.25, $1.50. The enamel dots, I mean. So those were a good price. That's why I bought so many, because I still really love to use those. All right, so this was called Scrapping for Less. So I got this piece of bling, and like I said, everything was a buck at this booth. And I needed that because I don't have that kind color of silver anymore, and I need it to fix, not even scrappy related, it's a pair of shoes that have bling on them like that. So I got some soft-spoken embellishments, which you know if you shop Michaels, these typically run $3.99 for a pack of these. So I got stars because I love stars. This cute little cocktails one. Americano one. I loved the little fireworks. And these cute dinosaurs for my boys, for Boy Scouts. They went to Dinosaur Ridge, so I thought that would be perfect. Let me move that away. It's kind of competing. I got the Tropical Getaway little kind of title. And then I got this cute little set of stars. And I got the travel one, which is epoxy. Cool Dude, which is epoxy, and then this adventure one, and then I bought two sets of these, and they look like flare to me. They're enamel circles, and they're school related, and I do Project Life for my kids' school books, and I have three kids, so I figured I'd get two packs for, you know, a dollar each, why not? And then the last thing I got at Scrapping for Less is this Echo Park Happy Holidays, a little sticker set. All right, and then I grabbed a couple die cuts. I usually buy like maybe one or two when I'm at the expo. It just depends on what I need a scrapbook, because I do have a Cameo and a Cricut, so I can make my own if, you know, I find the time to, but who wants to do that, right? So the first two I got were from Paper Wizard, and it's Anna and Elsa. I just thought they were adorable. And they were priced pretty reasonably. They were only $3.99. So I thought they were adorable. And then the other die cuts I got were from Petticoat Parlor. Got this gymnastics one. And then Olaf. He's adorable. And Yoda. And Kwai. So that was from Petticoat Parlor. And the next place that I bought was the last place that I'm going to share with you. I didn't go out crazy, you guys, but you're going to probably die when you see what I got from this next vendor. But it's my favorite booth, and it's called Scrap That. So I picked up 3 washi tapes. I got this cute anchor one, which I think is Teresa Collins. And then this adorable Halloween one. And then I got the Little People one, which I think is Teresa Collins as well. And those were $1 each. And I really didn't want to buy washi, but I got papers that went with a couple of those. So, all right, so I got a lot of embellishments at this booth. In my mind's eye, cut and paste these kind of enamel dots like this. And then I have this Christmas line, so I went ahead and I picked up this little embellishment, the decorative buttons to go with that I already have. And then I picked up the layered stickers in the Notable Memo. And the Kate and Co. layered stickers, the Cambridge Court. And layered stickers in Memorable Note, and the bits and pieces from the Cut and Paste Fresh Inspired. And then I got some buttons, and this is from the Cut and Paste Adorbs, and I also picked up this paper collection. And then Cupid's Arrows enamel dots. And those were adorable. So those were, and all these ranged from like $1 to $1.25 or something like that. So they were pretty cheap. So that was that Scrap That. And I also got some other stuff from Scrap That, and I'll share that in sets. So this is the Teresa Collins Family Stories, and I've wanted this collection. I have bits and pieces of it. So I bought what they had that I didn't have. So I got the decorative buttons. And then the little glittered borders. You get all these. And you guys have seen all this. This is anything new. And then the little photo corners. And then they didn't have a paper pack, so I just grabbed some random papers. And I think I got like 8 sheets of this paper to play with. And then I got the chipboard element. So that was the Teresa Collins Family Story. That was from that collection, and that's still at the same booth. And then at that booth, they had $3 paper packs, and this is the My Mind's Eye Cut and Paste Flare, and there's a little bit of what's in there, and there's just 12 papers in there. And to go with that, I did find this cute embellishment here, and I also got the stamp set from the Flare Snapshots. And I got it because it has the hashtag, and I really got it just for the hashtag. But I thought it was cute. And that was like $1 something. And the most expensive thing I bought at that booth was $10. And it is the Adorbs collection. You get 16 12 by 12 papers. Matching accessories including stickers, journaling, cards, enamel shapes, chipboard, and more. And so here's kind of a look at what you get in here, and then you get all the 16 papers in there. So I thought that was a good a good deal, and they're all, everything's in there. And I didn't get this collection, and I thought it was cute. Couldn't pass that up. And then the last collection that I picked up bits and pieces of from, which was really cheap, like these were like a dollar, was The Happy by Teresa Collins, You Are My Happy. So I got the sequins and the flags and the brads and then the border strips as well. And then they have this chipboard and then the paper collection. And this is like $3, you guys, and you get the 9 sheets and you get the sticker element sheet in there too. So it was a great deal, and I didn't plan on getting this much paper, but I loved all these little collections and that I could purchase all the little embellishments for like a buck or two. And so that was a selling feature for me, that I could get this whole collection for really cheap. So that is my haul from this Denver Scrapbook Expo. And I also was able to meet Rena Myers, which she's on YouTube here, and I'll put her link down below. Check her out. She's a fabulous crafter. She makes amazing shabby chic projects. So if you don't know who Rena is, go check out her channel. And you can see a picture of Rena and I on my Facebook, and I'll link that down below too. So guys, that's it for now. I probably won't be back for a little while. I'm going out of town for a scrapbook retreat. And so you'll see some projects coming up shortly in the next couple weeks probably for me. All right, guys, thanks so much for stopping by, and we will.